Hey, this is Overpass Insights. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today, dude, I got 3 app store rejections in the last 2 weeks. All right, so it is a beautiful morning here in England. It's sunny. It's going to get really, really hot today. So today is supposed to be the hottest day in English history. Right now it's like 9 o'clock in the morning as I film this. So it's like 23 degrees Celsius. They're expecting to get up to about 41 degrees Celsius, which I guess is like 100 and something. I'm not quite sure. I know a lot of you guys probably live in places that get a lot warmer than this, but for England, this is a big deal. There's certain, some of the schools are closed and everything like that. A lot of the functions have been shut down, everything like that. But, you know, at 9 o'clock in the morning, I'm loving it. So anyway, I'll go inside later and do my code and all that kind of stuff. Anyway, but today what I want to talk to you guys about was about Apple rejections. Because we, over the years, that's one of the constants of this channel, is when my apps get rejected, I tell you why, what you could do about it to fix it, how I've overcome those rejections, if I've been able to overcome those rejections, all that kind of stuff. And you get, you know, I've been rejected over the years so many times by Google Play and by Apple. And most of the time, I would say 90% of the time, I'm able to get it, you know, overturned or appealed or all this kind of stuff. So over the last 2 weeks, I've had 3 different app store rejections on the Apple side. Google Play's been fine over the last few weeks. 2 of them were client projects, and 1 of them was one of my own projects. So the 2 client projects I'm not too worried about because those were easy to fix, right? They were easy just, you know, one of them, you know, they got that new rule that if you are able to create an account within the app store, you need to be able to delete your account, right? And so that was easy to fix. Basically, I had to explain to them that it was not the kind of thing they thought based on this client project. Another one was we use the word free in the description, so that was something that that we had in it for previous versions. But it's one of those things, you're not allowed to say free or put the price in the description or in the screenshots, anything like that. And really, it's not really, a lot of times we think, especially as new developers come in, we think it's kind of a selling point, but it isn't. But this was not my, those are not my screenshots, you know. So it's one of those things. If you put your app out there, you might be able to get away with putting free in it, but there's no reason to. You'll get rejected for it. You could get rejected for it, and you'd have to fix it anyway. And it's not really that big a selling point. I mean, everything on the App Store and the Play Store is free. So those 2 were easy to fix, right? Easy to fix. But the other one was my own project, and I got hit with a 4.3 spam guideline, right? Now, over the years, this has been the bane of my existence with Apple App Store, right? I've had so many applications, and to be honest, they were all very similar to each other, but they had totally different target markets. They were for different language learning, you know, learning different languages and stuff like that. And because I had so many of them, they just started, you know, rejecting everything. Apple just started rejecting everything I put through. It said 4.3, you need to have a container application, right? So you need to combine everything into one application, which from an ASO and from a marketing point of view is just stupid, right? You're all of a sudden, you got something that is for totally different markets, but you gotta sell it as one product to loads of different people. And I just did not agree with that, right? If somebody had like a similar product, but only had like one language in it, they would do much better than me because I had multiple languages and all this kind of stuff. So anyway, Apple guidelines 4.3 sucks, right? So I got hit with that again. Basically, I released an application. This was a SaaS application that I've been working on for at least 6 months. I mean, it's been in the works for a few years, like in terms of the idea, and you know, one of these days I'm gonna work on this kind of stuff. So finally, you know, just did it over the last 6 months, and I've been dragging my feet a little bit, you know, just putting it on the App Store. So finally, when I did, I wasn't expecting any trouble, and then I got the 4.3, and I rejected it, and I got the 4.3 again, which is just got me right there. Now, normally, I'll just keep appealing. You know, just keep appealing, and they'll start to respond slower and slower, because, you know, whatever. So it's better if you actually just release a new build so they can reevaluate it. So I appealed it once, you know, just said, look, it's different than the other applications. I don't know why you're giving me 4.3. And they were just like, you know, nope, right? The thing is, at that same time, I came down with COVID. So, like, it wasn't just the rejection. I mean, I just started to feel really, like, really sorry for myself. If you guys ever been rejected, you might get this. Like, you're like, oh, what's the point? Why even bother? I didn't know it at the time, but I'd come down with COVID, and I tested positive, you know, a few days later, and it was just like my energy levels were low. So, like, I wasn't even bother, like, doing anything with it. And I would just, like, I wrote it off, like, well, that was a stupid mistake. How embarrassing, right? But, you know, finally, when my energy levels came back, it's like, you know what? No, let's appeal again. So most of the time when you get a rejection, it's well, on the Google Play side, rejection is usually algorithm based. So you just have to, like, appeal it, or, you know, respond so that you get somebody to actually review it, like, you know, review it. But on the Apple side, it's, you know, it's a reviewer. And sometimes they just don't have all the information. So basically what I did was I just, you know, continue to tell them stuff, make sure I go in into the developer notes or into the reviewer notes and put in, like, okay, this may seem similar to other applications, but it's different because of this way, this way, this way. And eventually it was, you know, it was approved. And it was like, yes, right? What the thing I get emailed about the most from other developers is, my app was rejected. I saw your video about this. What can I do about it? And the answer is always the same. You know, you got to appeal it, and you got to provide more information, right? And if you appeal it and they're like, nope, we still say no. On the Google Play side, I find it better to just resubmit a new build and just, you know, and if you can, like, if they'll allow you to, if it's actually rejected, like suspended, then you need to, you know, you need to appeal that. But if it's just like a, you know, they denied the build or whatever, just release a new one, you know, even if you make minor changes to it, and explain to them in the developer notes why it's different, you know, because they don't have all the information based on that short time they're able to look at your application. And the same with the Apple side. The first time with Apple, if you get a rejection from a build, you know, just respond to the review. Most of the time, that's what all you have to do. Sometimes you might have to just fix something and release a new build, but most of the time, you know, it goes through just fine. Unless you have something that's, the one time I did have something that was not salvageable was a client project where they did not like the concept at all. And no matter how much I appealed this thing, it just wasn't going to fly. We had to redo that thing as a PWA. That was expensive for the client, but, you know, those are the kind of things to worry about. So anyway, App Store rejections, they happen. I mean, over the years, I've had so many of them. I don't know why this time. I think it was the low energy levels. I just let it get to me. But these kind of things happen. Anyway, let me know, what was the last time your app was rejected? And do you have an app that was rejected and you were never able to get it back? Because sometimes you have to peel these things more than once. There's, like, there've been times I have to appeal three, four, five times just to get something back on the App Store or the Play Store. You know, no doesn't always mean the final no. So anyway, I hope this is helpful. I hope you guys are having a great day. Thank you for liking and subscribing and all that kind of stuff. You know, it really helps the algorithm. That is it for today. I'll talk to you guys again next time.